Like, if you use these words every single time, like, instant dramatic moment. But 10 years ago, if you'd have told me that Richard Dawkins is going to defend something that Christians are doing, I would call you insane. I mean, if you'd have wrote a book on a subject, I would say it's too far-fetched. You know, I would more likely be willing to believe that a man was bitten by a radioactive pig and then got fat than to believe something like this. If you don't know who Richard Dawkins is, he's quite famous. He's one of the people who led the counter-push against creationists and people who try to push intelligent design into schools and creationism into schools, you know, as being scientific. Religion is religion, okay? You need to have faith in order to believe that those things happened. It's not scientific. So when you try to mix the two, obviously it's not going to work out. And Richard Dawkins was one of the people that came with facts, that came with evidence, and, you know, like, prove that creationism is not science. Right? It can be philosophy, if you will. It can be spiritual. It's religious, but it's not science. So I am shocked to see now that Richard Dawkins is defending the right for Christians to pretty much have an ad in UK cinema. So the Church of England had issued a statement saying it was disappointed and bewildered after leading United Kingdom cinemas refused to show an ad featuring the famous Christian words. So, in other words, let me explain you how it works. A religious bakery does not have the right not to write on a gay wedding cake that marriage is between a gay couple, okay? They don't have that right to do that. They can be fined and their bakery gets shut down. However, because it's discrimination, right? Discrimination based on sexual orientation. However, a UK cinema can refuse to show an ad based on religious discrimination. Really interesting, by the way, because if you look at human rights, discrimination is done on race, gender, age, sex, religion. I mean, but I guess we can't have all. Personally, I would, of course, I would take down religion as a part of discrimination because anyone can change their religion. But just, you know, like, I'm trying to understand how things work here. Now, of course, cinemas are private businesses, right? And if they don't want to show something, they can choose not to. The question is, why do they choose not to, right? Why would they not want to take the money from religious people in order to show, right? What is the reason behind this? And it seems that the reason is that the adverts could offend those of different faiths and no faith. So they're concerned about the atheists. And it seems that Richard Dawkins, along with 80% other atheists, agree that this is not offensive, right? You can go in a cinema and you can see the Lord's Prayer. And at the same time, they are afraid not to offend other people of different faiths. They're afraid not to offend the Muslims and the Jews. That's so sweet. That is very sweet. The church hit back, calling the decision plain silly, and warned it could have a chilling effect on free speech because it's virtue signaling. This is what it is. The UK cinemas want to show how inclusive and loving they are, that they're so inclusive, they include everyone but the Christians, which are probably the majority of the population, unless I'm mistaken. I don't know the recent polls in UK, but I do think, you know, probably the majority of population identifies as Christians. So they're so inclusive, they just fail to include the majority. But everything else is inclusive, right? And they also fail to include the atheists because apparently the atheists don't agree with this decision. But other than that, they're very inclusive. Yeah, okay. So, and when an Express poll asked, should the Lord's Prayer be banned, a massive 82% said no. It was against free speech, with only 16% agreeing it should not be aired, and the remaining 2% said they did not know. Now the church has received support from an unlikely source, Mr. Dawkins, who said he was against the suppression of the prayer. He said, I strongly object suppressing of ads on the grounds that they might offend people. If anyone is offended by something so trivial as a prayer, they deserve to be offended. I mean, yeah, why would you be offended? I'm an atheist, okay? If I see going in a cinema and I see Lord's Prayer, I'm like, yeah, okay, whatever, I don't believe in that shit. Why would I be offended? I just don't understand. The church hoped the 60 seconds film, which features the Lord's Prayer being recited or sung by a variety of people, would be screened in cinemas across the UK before Christmas, ahead of the new Star Wars film. So it was like a Christmas event, you know, and I can see why the church is trying to take back Christmas, because if you look even at the show Arrow, which is a show aimed at teenagers mostly with superheroes and whatnot, even in that show, Oliver Queen is saying, oh, I'm getting ready for the Christmas party. And Felicity Smoke, his girlfriend, is saying holiday. Like, she is correcting him. Again, she is virtue signaling, saying how inclusive she is, that we should call it a holiday, not to marginalize Muslims and other non-Christians from taking part into the Christmas celebrations, which are, of course, about buying presents and spending as much cash as possible. So, of course, we want more inclusivity in that. And it seems the church is not alone. Express.co.uk showed that the majority of respondents also believed it should be screened. The adverts include refugees, weightlifters, the Archbishop of Canterbury, and most blah, blah, blah. The film was approved by the British board, but the Digital Cinema Media Agency, which handles British film advertising for the major cinema chains, refused to show it because it believed it could upset or offend audiences. How can you be offended? I just don't understand. If I would go into, let's say, Turkey, and I would see in the cinemas Allah Akbar, some shit, why would I be offended? I don't understand. It's mind-boggling, okay? Right, so you get the idea. And let's see one of the reasons why Richard Dawkins cares about this issue. Because honestly, I this is my belief, I would normally not care about defending Christianity. But if we look less than a month later, praise Allah bar slogans get green-lighted. So Lord's Prayer is offensive. However, praise Allah is able to appear on buses. Now, of course, I understand different companies, right? But it's the idea, like the idea of it all, the image that it's portraying. I mean, if I was now the, what was it called? The DCM, DCM Digital Cinema Media Agency. When I would see this in the news, it's like, okay, so if ads having Allah and Islam get a free pass, you know, we changed our minds. We changed our minds. We allow the Lord's Prayer to be public because, well, you know. But no, that's not it, okay? Because apparently seeing praise Allah in a country that's predominantly with a population that has Christian and atheists is not offensive and marginalizing, right? Imagine it like seeing in Saudi Arabia the David Star and Shalom on a bus. How do you think people would react there? I'm just wondering, you know. So, the slogan reads, Subna Allah, which translates as glory be to God. And will feature on hundreds of buses across the country by the Islamic Relief. The group have targeted the ad campaign to raise money for victims of Syrian civil war during the holy month of Ramadan in June. But the campaign has caused anger among some Christian groups after an advert featuring the Lord's Prayer was banned from UK cinemas. And I can understand, you know, I really do have sympathy. Because if you want to ban religious ads, fine, you know, but ban all religions. Don't give a free pass to one religion and, you know, the others are being silenced. Like, you silence the religion of the majority in favor of the religion of the minority. So audience are capable of hearing expressions of Christian faith, blah, blah, blah. And this is not just on UK, by the way. If you look at Google, and you Google Google Easter versus Google Ramadan, And I showed this in a previous video. I'm just showing it again because a lot of people don't know it, and it's important to point out. This is how Google celebrates Easter and how they celebrate Ramadan. You know, and this is a multi-million dollar company. Like, look here. In fact, the last Easter, Google decided to celebrate Cesar Chavez, which is a leftist activist, I understand, instead of celebrating Easter. I mean, you know, it's like these kinds of double standards. Unwillingly, you are taking a position. You know, you are saying that Christianity is bad. You know, as an atheist, I can understand and sympathize with you. You know, I do think religions are bad. But when I see that you are promoting Islam, and instead you are saying Christianity is horrible, then we have some disagreements, because I don't think I want to live in an Islamic society. I think it's horrible, especially when I see news like this that's often being covered up. And by the way, I'm reading from Mad World News. However, this news also appears in the Daily Mail. Which apparently a talent agency boss is charged and held in custody for inciting racial hatred over a tweet about quizzing a Muslim woman over the Brussels terror attack. So tweets are now something which can get you locked up. Yeah, like if you are in the safety of your own home, in the comfort of your own home at the internet, simply tweeting something like pressing a sequence of keys on your keyboard and pressing enter is now considered a public menace. There are people out there who are Islamic preachers saying that people who draw the prophet need to be beheaded. And they're not arrested, they're not locked up, they're not deported, you know. But people who apparently tweet something, they're the problem. I mean, if you Google Islamists, like, look here. These are some people that are found in Europe. Maybe you are in America and you don't get these type of people, right? They are the Islamists. And to make sure that people understand, Muslim and Islamists are two different things. A Muslim can be an Islamist. An Islamist is a Muslim, but not all Muslims are Islamists. This is the thing. An Islamist is someone who takes his religion to political levels, right? He wants to indoctrinate other people into Islam, and he wants the world to become Islamic. And you get to see these people, like freedom of expression, go to hell, and these kinds of things, you know, which are, of course, God bless it, right, which are, of course, offensive, but you don't see these people being locked up. I mean, look here, you slay those who insult Islam, Europe, you will pay. These things, they're okay. You can say these things. Sharia will dominate the world. This is perfectly acceptable. Oh, look at these fine beauties. Look here. Look at these ladies. Where was it? Behead those who insult Islam. There was a picture. Sharia for France. Islam, the solution for France. I mean, they get to say whatever the fuck they want. But the moment you sit under the comfort of your own bedroom and you say, I confronted a Muslim woman yesterday in Croydon, I asked her to explain Brussels, she said, nothing to do with me. I mean, okay, I get it, you know, maybe this person is a disrespectful individual, okay, he is a potty mouth, you know, he does not have manners, but since when are we arresting people for not having manners? I approach a white man, ask him to explain Anders Breivik. You are a white middle-aged man. I demand your accountant for dumplings. So, this person asked a Muslim woman something, right? She said nothing to do with her, and that was that. And then other people are also asking him pretty much the same things. These three people are not going to be arrested. However, this guy is arrested. In other words, let me explain to you if they. Okay, let's say that a crime is committed. You punch someone in the face, right? And now three other people come and they punch you in the face. In a normal civilized society, all four of the people who punched someone else in the face would be arrested because they all four committed a crime. Doesn't matter the context, doesn't matter the consequences, they will all be arrested. However, in this case, this is considered hate speech. This is considered acceptable. What is justice? This is not justice. I'm sorry. This is like a by the by. I don't even know why exactly I posted. Liberal teacher takes in Muslim refugee. His colleague finds what's left of him. And this is also from the New York Times. However, I'm going to read it from Mad World News because it's a lot more summarized. The reason I wanted to show it is because it's quite gruesome, okay? And I understand it's this is not the majority of the cases, right? So it's just one case where we know that this happened. But this is what a lot of tolerance and putting reason aside is doing to people. You know, there is this program in Germany called Open Your Doors or something like that. And it's about taking a refugee inside your own home. I mean, what bad can happen? Like, I am really curious what can happen when you take a member that's from a theocratic state where religion is the thing that dominates their entire life, and you put them into a secularist state with, you know, people who can be atheists, who can be open-minded, who can have disagreements. Well, this is an example. So a leftist professor decided to put into practice his own liberal open doors policy, feeding and housing a poor Muslim refugee in his own home. However, when colleagues showed up to find why he wasn't at work, he found stomach-churning thrill that's enough for anyone to abandon their progressive multicultural beliefs. So the people of this, according to the New York Times, the people of this community are incredibly shocked because they don't really get murders in their town. But now, thanks to multiculturalism, they have to understand that different cultures have different standards. And not only that, but apparently the reason he got killed is over a disagreement. So Mehdi was murdered because his compassion and ignorance met its match with the Islamic ideology inherent in Sharia countries. As a witness to Islamic brutality in his own home, the propaganda on the left took advantage of his sympathy. Come on, show me the nitty-gritty. So this coincidence report, 4 out of 5 refugees are not from Syria or even weren't our nations. Yeah, this is something that politicians never addressed. It's like, if you want refugees, why are they coming from places that don't have a war? You know, it's like they're not seeking refuge. Why aren't you taking the people from Ukraine, Germany? You know, they are actually running from Donetsk, a place where they do have war, and their government is actually prosecuting them if they return because they fled from the war. They fled from the draft. And Germany is like, nope, back you go. Muslims, come in. So, I don't want this video to go too long. So, from what I understand, like, he had a disagreement. Okay, so murdered by the very migrant from whom he cared, Meldi's tolerance for the 58-year-old Afghan refugee came full swing when police say they got into an argument. According to Bild, upset Mehdi, the man who gave him everything, simply disagreed with him. The unidentified asylum seeker took a rock and a large metal instrument. Wait, a rock and a large metal instrument? Like, two-handed type of fight, dual-wielding, bash, 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 and bashed the teacher's head to a bloody pulp. He then dragged the mutilated body down the basement in an attempt to cover up his gruesome crime. Although the migrant suspect was arrested, German police were hesitant to give out many details. Of course, why would they want to fuel more into the hatred and perhaps, you know, like, shut down this god-awful program with giving houses to immigrants? Apparently, in case you don't know, Germany took over 1 million refugees last year, according to the New York Times. Let's see what it was, because it was... Still, like, gigantic number, it's madness. You know, this is not immigration, okay? This is not immigration, this is something else. Open borders should not exist along with the welfare state. If you'd have a perfect capitalist society where welfare doesn't exist, that's fine. You know, I don't care if the borders are open or not. But when you have a society where you have welfare and I pay my own taxes to the state in the hopes that my own taxes are going to be invested into healthcare, education, and all that kind of thing, I don't understand why other people can simply come in and benefit from the system that I'm paying into.